The year was 1992. Most people carried pagers, and few privileged ones had email, and that was in Silicon Valley. On November 14th, 20 successful Indo-American executives were waiting to meet Mr. N. Vital, Secretary of Electronics, to talk about liberalization in India, but his flight was delayed.
We had to find a way to keep everyone engaged over lunch, so we chose to share our life stories.
At that time, we had no organized way for Indo-Americans to network. So when I proposed getting together,
guys, why don't we do this on a regular basis, once a month? And everybody wholeheartedly agreed.
So a group of us got together on December 22, 1992, at the San Jose Hilton to form an entrepreneurs club. This was the genesis of TiE.
By March 1993, a group of seven individuals created an organization to facilitate networking. This team of seven became the founding team of the Indus Entrepreneurs.
We called it Indus to be inclusive of all of the Indian subcontinent. We made US uppercase since we all live here in the United States. And when Ray Vidula shortened the name to TiE, everybody just loved it.
Roy Prasad came up with a logo which he thought was sloppy. We can't believe this logo lasted 25 years.
The team arranged monthly networking meetings that featured prominent speakers. By mid-1993, the third Tuesday of every month became TiE Dinner Day amongst a fast-growing circle of entrepreneurs.
AJ Patel led the efforts, and for 2 years, he ran TiE as the DBA under his name. AJ also shared the facilities and resources of his company for TiE operations.
In August 1993, the founding team invited Suhas Patel to join the team and elected him as the first president of TiE.
The energy of the team and the idea of giving back really got me excited.
Then in March 1994, TiE held a two-day entrepreneurs workshop at the San Jose Fairmont. It was a bold move with no certainty as to whether such an event would be successful.
We planned for 300 people, and over 500 showed up. Many volunteers made this possible. Praveen Gupta renamed the conference to TiEcon, a name that still lives on.
Volunteers are the backbone of TiE, and these volunteers become part of TiE family.
In August 1994, 27 people signed on as the founding charter members of TiE.
Charter members are successful entrepreneurs committed to mentoring the next generation of aspiring entrepreneurs. Kanwar Rekhi is one of the most visible and influential charter member.
In September 1994, TiE was formally incorporated as a not-for-profit organization. Fast forward to 1996, and Kanwar Rekhi became the second president of TiE.
We at TiE believe that wealth creation through entrepreneurship is a noble activity. This is the message we want to deliver to the whole world.
Our vision was always to make TiE a global organization. That vision started taking shape in 1997 when TiE started expanding beyond Silicon Valley to Southern California and Boston.
Being entrepreneurial is one of the most fulfilling ways to lead a life, and the most successful and a powerful platform to promote entrepreneurship is TiE.
By 1998, TiE had decided to engage with policymakers in India. We held a seminar in New Delhi that led to the formation of three chapters in India.
We helped in the setup and growth of the TiE chapters in India, and also deeply engaged with government, helping enable policies that have successfully created an extremely vibrant, successful entrepreneurial ecosystem today.
Based on a model outlined by the late C.K. Prahlad in the House of TiE, TiE Global was created in 2000.
TiE Silicon Valley became a bridge to success for entrepreneurs worldwide. We also organized the first ever TiE Global Summit in Delhi.
In 25 years, TiE has inspired entrepreneurs to create hundreds of startups that led to thousands of new jobs and estimated to have created $200 billion in new wealth.
Going forward, we need to establish the brand TiE with the youth, starting from schools to colleges to startups with a special emphasis on women entrepreneurship. With our established program like TYE, we want to make TiE University and TiE Women even stronger. The TiE Angels program in the US and now in India has already made TiE the go-to organization for startups. We also want to expand our work with governments across the world to make policy more conducive for cross-border investments.
Much has changed since 1992, but from pagers to smartphones, TiE's mission has stood the test of time. TiE continues to march as a vibrant, forward-looking entity that strives to add value to entrepreneurs worldwide.